A very good afternoon to all of you, and welcome Vikas to our channel Education.
And after that, I worked about 10 years in Japan, particularly in Tokyo, as a software engineer and then manager.
Okay. So what prompted you to leave?
So after looking all the opportunities and all, and future of me and my family, I finally decided to come back to Japan.
Like, how was that change? Like, please share with us.
Determination and I think planning, two things were there. Okay. And currently we are undergoing training in IGNFA.
Any specific books that you would like to recommend, or did you take coaching and all?
Like, I started from the SME. So I want to study as minimum as required.
Very good afternoon to all of you, and welcome Vikas to our channel Education. Please tell our viewers something about yourself.
My name is Vikas Yadav. I belong to Jaipur, Rajasthan. I have done engineering in electronics and communication. I passed out in 2006. And after that, I worked about 10 years in Japan, particularly in Tokyo, as a software engineer and then manager. So after that, after working 10 years there, I thought of preparing of this examination. And then I started preparation of this examination. In my second attempt, I cleared this exam.
So what prompted you to leave? I mean, I'm sure it must have been a well-paying job.
Yeah, actually, when I went to Japan, in my mind, I always had this thought that I will never settle in Japan. I will always settle in India. Then I have a daughter, and she was about 2.5 years old that time. So I have to think about her schooling, her future also. And I had to decide, like, finally where I want to settle. And I already decided, like, in the beginning of my career, that I will settle in India only. So after looking all the opportunities and all, and future of me and my family, I finally decided to come back to India.
So as you shared, you left a job of almost a decade, you were saying. So it must have been such a huge and big responsibility on your shoulder, you being a family man. So like, how was that change? Like, please share with us.
Yeah, definitely. Actually, leaving a job after 10 years, where I was well settled, and my salary is also very handsome. And so after looking all this, is very difficult to leave a job and decide for a new career, which I did not know anything.
Right.
So yeah, it is quite challenging. But what I want to say that I planned it well. I planned that I said to myself that, okay, let me give 2 years of my life for this examination. And because I was working in Japan, so I saved pretty much so that I can survive for next 2 and 3 years without earning anything. And so I convinced my family also regarding this, and I planned well that, okay, let me give 2 years of my life. If nothing will happen, then there is so much opportunity available in the market. Private job is always there. So yes, determination and I think planning, two things were there.
Yes, it was a big leap of faith that you took, actually. So how did you begin your studies? Any specific books that you would like to recommend, or did you take coaching and all?
Okay, so let me further explain about my preparation. As I said that after 10 years of working there, and you might be surprised to know that I don't know anything about the civil service examination. Like, I started from the scratch. So for the prelims 2017, I studied all the thing myself. Slowly and gradually, I started gathering material, mostly the online sources I followed, and the material is also available, online material, like all the NCERT books are available, you can download them, and then mostly I did my study on my laptop only. So I downloaded all the material and I started preparing for that. So this by this way, I started my preparation. Yes, of course, there was a problem that, because I didn't know anything. So in the beginning, like in the starting 6 or 7 months, I followed so much sources, so much books. And after about 1 year, I realized that I studied the books I don't need to study, basically.
Okay.
Yeah. So, yes, so some material, because, you know, if somebody is there to guide you or you are doing the coaching, then this is, I think, the benefit for you, that you know what to study.
How did you start moving towards the right books?
As I said, that I started with the minimum material. Mm. So, of course, like after starting study after 10 years is very a difficult task for me. So I want to study as minimum as required. due to all these reasons, I go for the minimum material. Okay. I actually saw many videos of toppers, mm-hmm. and whoever said the minimum material, I went for that. So I think this helped me also, because in market, if you go, there is so much material available, and we are always confused that which to follow. Yeah. We should concise ourselves to one kind of material, and we mm-hmm. should study that again and again.
So, didn't you think that you should try for IAS or other? But why Forest Services?
I started preparing for civil service only, and in the first attempt, I did not clear prelims. Mm-hmm. In second attempt, I cleared prelims and with a sufficient margin, so that I can qualify for the Indian Forest Service examination also. And from that time, I started learning about the Forest Service examination. I studied what is this exam, what is the opportunity this job will provide me, mm-hmm. and in what kind of field I need to work. So after that, I started loving this one. Like when I was working in Japan also, then also I, in the back of my mind, I like something close to the nature, close to the trees, wildlife. That I wanted always.
So, how has your training been like as a forest officer?
Yes, training is amazing. Actually, in the beginning, we did foundation course. People from all service are present in the foundation course. Mm. And we got to know each other. We have lots of lectures. Mm. But apart from this, we have in the morning physical training also we have. We have games. And the infrastructure is one of the best infrastructure there. Mm-hmm. And apart from that, their cultural program. So basically, all around development of person happens there.
What is the duration of the foundation course?
It is about 100 days, 3 months and 3.5 months approximately.
Okay. And then after the foundation course?
Yeah, after foundation course in December, we joined our professional course mm-hmm. in IGNFA, Dehradun, Indira Gandhi National Forest Academy. Mm-hmm. Now here it is professional course, so we want to, they are teaching us more in our field-related things. Like if we are going to work in forest area, then about forest administration, forest laws, mm-hmm. The technical things, GIS and all what we can use in our forests and wildlife. Mm-hmm. So it is more about our core field. Apart from them, yes, there are amazing tours are there in which we visit or approximately whole India. Yeah, so basically training is about your all around development, because physical training is a essential part of the training. Mm-hmm. And in the evening, the sports is also essential part. Mm-hmm. Apart from that, in cultural events, we have lot of opportunity to discover ourselves. I myself also first time in my life danced there only.
Oh, wow.
So
great.
So it is quite a great experience in the training, which also develop us for the future.
So what are your job responsibilities as a forest service officer?
Our responsibility will be mainly related to the forest and wildlife.
Okay.
And environment.
Mm-hmm.
To protect forest, to regenerate them, mm-hmm. to protect wildlife.
Okay.
To fulfill the mandate given by the government through the various acts and policies.
So, any words of advice, if you want to give to those aspirants who are planning to take a shift in their maybe career path and what should they study more or what should they not study at all?
This exam is about three things for me. Like first, determination. Second is dedication, and third one is diligence.
Right.
So first is determination. Is like you have to determine your that okay, you want to go for this exam. I think if this exam is like is one of the toughest exam, and if you have second thought in mind that okay, let me give this exam, or I will give this exam and then I will do this, and then it's quite difficult to clear this exam. So determine that you will do this, you will give this exam, and you will dedicate yourself. That okay, you have decided now you are going for this exam, and now you have to dedicate yourself. You have to do very hard work, like continuous, like say 8 to 10 hours daily.
Okay.
From the first day to the day you got selected in this exam.
Yes.
And the second thing is minimize your material. Because I have seen some of my friends, like they are studying, and then they always say that they cannot clear this exam. They are studying very hard, but I figured out that okay, they are doing mistake is that they follow a particular material, and then next year they are following some different material.
Okay.
And so yes, so better is that follow one material, one book. And revise that again and again.
Yeah, sorry to interrupt, but do you have any particular book list which you are following? Maybe we can share it with our viewers.
Yes, I can share if somebody needs.
Because it will be of great help, especially for those students who are like just beginning.
Yeah, definitely. I can share.
Great, thank you. So thank you so much, Vikas, for your time, and it was great talking to you. And wish you all the best for all your future endeavors.
Thank you very much for this support, for giving me this opportunity to share my experience. I think that it may help somebody
yes.
During their preparation. Thank you very much.